As you probably already know, when you build apps today, you'll likely need to use animations and transitions to enhance the UI where possible. With Angular's animation framework, we have access to some pretty powerful features which allow us to do things that may not be possible with CSS alone. In this video, we're going to look at a little fun and crazy example using the Angular keyframes animation function. All right, let's get to it. Before we get too far along, it's important to note here that I've already created a couple of videos focused on the animation framework. First, I've got an animation basics video where I cover how to include the animations module and then how to use some of the basic functions of the API to create a simple state-based animation. Then I've got a video where we build off the example in the first video and change to animate items as they're added and removed from the DOM with the enter and leave aliases. So if you're not familiar with these concepts, the examples in this video might not make as much sense as they would if you were to watch them first. Okay, onto the example for this video. We've been working on this demo application for the Van Shoe brand. We have this menu that we've set up to transition in from the right when it's opened and then out to the right when it's closed. What we want to do now is we want to change this animation to something a little more crazy like this, where it has multiple different things going on as it transitions from one state to another. I know this is a pretty crazy example, and we probably wouldn't really want to do this sort of thing in the real world, but in this case, it's a perfect opportunity to explore how the keyframes function works. This function is yet another powerful piece of the animations API. It accepts a parameter of steps. These steps consist of an array of animation style metadata objects, which are essentially objects of styles for each keyframe step. So let's start by modifying our existing animation to use keyframes to see if we can pull off this crazy animation. Here we can see the enter and leave animation that we added in the previous video. There's no need for us to change away from an enter and leave animation, so we'll leave that aspect alone for now. Let's start with the enter transition. We can remove the old style function because it's not needed with the way keyframes work. Now, to use the keyframes function, we still need to use the animation function. So we can add the keyframes function as the second parameter. And we need to be sure that it gets imported too. Okay, so we need to pass this function an array of steps. And guess what? These steps are going to look super familiar from our previous examples because we used the style function to define the styles for each step in our animation. To pull off this animation, we should be able to do it all with transforms. So let's add a transform. Now we'll pass it the transform styles as a string. We need it to start off the screen to the right, so let's go with a translate x of 120% like we used in our old example. Also, let's add a scale of 0.5 to shrink it down. Okay, that's our first step. For the second step, let's bring it into our page before we rotate it. Let's go ahead and duplicate our first step. Then let's change our translate x value to negative 120% this time, and we'll leave the scale as is. Let's duplicate this step now. This is going to be the step where we rotate the menu. So we'll leave the translate x value at negative 120. Let's increase the scale a little to 0.65. And now let's add a rotate function. Here we'll rotate the menu 360 degrees to rotate in a complete circle. Okay, for the last step, let's duplicate this again. Here we'll want to translate to our final position, so we'll give it a value of 0. We'll also want to scale to our final value, so let's give it a value of 1. And we'll leave the rotate as is because if we were to remove it, the menu would rotate back to zero, which we don't want it to do. Okay, let's save this and see how we did. Okay, that looks great, much like the original example. One thing I don't like, though, is that I feel like the rotation happens really fast. I'd rather slow that chunk of the animation down. Well, with CSS keyframes, this is possible because we can just adjust the percentage of time a specific range in a keyframe animation will take. Well, we can do the same with the keyframes function. As part of the animation style metadata object, we have an offset property that we can use. This defines the point in the animation where the style change occurs. When we leave the offsets off like we did here, each change is offset an equal amount. So first change happens at an offset of 0. The second change occurs at an offset of 0.33. The third change occurs at an offset of 0.66. And the final change occurs at 1. So let's change these a little so the rotation period takes a little longer. We'll leave the first step at 0, but we'll change the second step to 0.1 so that it'll happen much quicker. Also, let's adjust the third step so that it takes a little longer. Let's go with 0.6 instead. Okay, let's save and try this again. Nice, that's a little better. It's pretty subtle, but you get the point, right? You can adjust the keyframe durations as needed for your animations. Okay, let's add the close animation now. We can start by copying our open animation, and we'll paste that over our existing close animation code. Okay, so now we pretty much need to reverse the order here to do the opposite transition on close. So let's move the last step to the top, and we'll switch its offset to 0. Now let's move up the rotation step and then change its offset to 0.1. And then we need to flip the last two steps and update their offsets too. Okay, now that we have these inverted, let's save and see if we got it right. Nice. Looks right when we close now, right? So again, this is a pretty crazy example. It's really just used in this case to illustrate how keyframes work in Angular. I don't recommend that you make menus that transition like this in production applications. But now, at least, you should have an understanding of how keyframes can be used. Now, just like I mentioned in the last two videos on Angular animations, there's a lot to the animation framework, so I'll go ahead and stop here for now. But I will be creating several more videos covering much more on Angular animations very soon. I hope this was helpful. Until next time, thanks for watching.